So basic question, why did you decide to run for mayor?
When or why?
Why?
So as my second term comes to an end as county supervisor, and I have so many programs in motion, vocational education, brand new super big program for this entire county I'm working on, that's just coming to fruition or launch, if you will. The homeless plan I've worked on, $50, $60 million given to all of our cities, including Stockton, in partnership with existing shelters or creating new ones. I need to bring that to fruition. There's so many things. We've got public safety, jobs, and industry coming here and making sure that Stockton's not left behind. So I'll be able to roll over all of the success we've had in the county and focus on Stockton, where there are some challenges.
Yeah, I was just going to ask you, you know, talk about your experience in your current role and how you believe that'll kind of help you if you were to be elected mayor.
Well, the best thing that's going to help me and the best indication to me is results. We had public safety issues in San Joaquin County. Well, when our sheriff needed resources, we as a board made sure we partnered with the sheriff and their needs and satisfied the recruitment, retaining. We even, mid-contract, I spearheaded the effort. They were 25% below the median in the county to be paid our deputies. I opened up the contract, got them up to the middle, 25% pay raise. So instead of losing officers, they came back. That's quality of life. That's public safety. That's a paramount issue. Homelessness, I spearheaded the effort to pivot away from housing first, which is not the answer for everybody. We need, and we could be more effective with dollars if we're doing shelters in partnership with local, nonprofit, faith-based organizations, making sure that individuals, pets, partners, possessions, all of it comes together with support services, right? Drug treatment, behavior health, whatever it takes to help a person get stable so that they're able to transition to supportive housing, back to being productive and healthy in the quality of life that they want to leave and live ultimately.
You know, there's a lot of issues that are facing voters in Stockton. You mentioned a couple of them, public safety, homelessness. I know it's hard to really narrow it down, you know, per se, but what would you say is your top priority and what you would tackle first head on if you were elected?
So simple and easy, homelessness is number one. I've done polling. Everybody wants it and wants to help. It's a humanitarian crisis, and we have a pathway to success that we've initiated. I'm going to make sure we see it through. And this is, again, in partnership. So government's not the total answer, but the government is part of a partnership and a utility of resources and incorporating all of the different, you know, departments, different elements of support services that needs to come together. When we found there's gaps, we've just recently in the county stood up what's going to be a basic large umbrella approach to give these support services to all of the different agencies, nonprofit, and local organizations so that we can help the individuals as they come in off the streets to a better place. So that's number one, is going to be satisfying that call to action, that humanitarian crisis. Public safety, 100% needs to happen. We know that there's things that make the headlines, and there is unfortunately a lot of tragedy that goes on. Every single challenge we have, there's an answer and a pathway to a better. Nothing stops crime better than a job, right? Well, this vocational education program that I'm launching in partnership with Delta College, in partnership with Manteca Education Career Training, in partnership with County Office of Education, in partnership with San Joaquin County Builders Exchange. We've got partners, public-private partners, coming together, working and fulfilling that gateway to a job, right? When you start getting jobs, you have less gang activity. You have less criminal activity. So that's on the forefront of what I need to do. Family entertainment. How about we revitalize downtown, the Miracle Mile? We could create an epicenter of economy. How about we bring in a convention center, a hotel, music venue, family entertainment? Let's create the nucleus of activity and financial vitality right here in downtown that now spawns outward. We have needs in South Stockton. We have needs in North Stockton. We need to create family recreation and zones of activity so that our quality of life, the quality of life that our families, our children, and the quality of life that our community can offer needs to be brought forward.
Taking it back to homelessness for a second, I know you said, you know, you're an advocate for this kind of shelter first model. Can you just briefly describe what the difference between that is and what the city of Stockton is currently doing?
Sure. Well, everybody sits around waiting for funding, okay? the federal funding and statewide even, they're primarily focused on housing first. And the theory is if you house them, then they're stable, and then they'll get into rehab. And it's not working out that way. In some areas, locally 25%, in some areas up to 45% of people are dead in the first 5 years because they're not sober. They're not. There's not even a requirement for them to pay rent. They don't pay utilities. They don't pay for their food delivery or their drug delivery or clean needles or anything else. They're just in this housing environment in perpetuity, no change in their habits. There's no metrics of success. So that's fine. I'm not here to stop any program, but what else can we do? That may work for some people. Some people may be on a merry-go-round, but if we can get the people that are living on the streets, on the roadways, our waterways, the highways, public and private land, and we can bring them into a place with support services where there's some human dignity. Think about this. If we wouldn't leave an animal abandoned next to a roadway, why are we leaving human beings that might be defensive, may be resistant, they certainly have health and food and safety issues at you know, being at risk? Why would, if we wouldn't leave an animal there, why would we possibly leave another human being to live? And truthfully, there are people getting beat up every night. There are women that are violated every night. There are terrible things. There are people that are dying on roadways, stumbling out into the streets or highways in the middle of the day or the night. There are tragedies that unfold around this consistent, I think, tolerance as if this is okay. So we know that there's a metrics to accomplish, and if we have shelter beds, then we can put together a crisis response teams, get people off the streets, engage with them, and bring them to a place of stability.
How many more shelter beds do you, is there a ballpark number of a shelter bed number that you want to achieve and reach that
sure.
compared to what we are at now?
So countywide, roughly, we have about, I think we're gonna have roughly 1,200 new shelter beds coming online. Now, what we've seen in some regions of the state, when they start engaging and enforcing and having shelter beds offered, there's a formula that's widely adopted as normal, what you can expect, 60-40. 60% will go in, 40% will be like, well, I'm not even from here. I'm going to go elsewhere. Well, we can connect them to elsewhere. The city of Manteca, on their own, I have no claim to this, city of Manteca has an officer, Mike Kelly, that in the last 5 years, he's gotten probably almost 400 people off the streets. One-way ticket back home, connect with their family, and reunite them. That's a model of success. Why aren't we doing that countywide? Why aren't we doing that in all parts? So Tracy's launched similar, Lodi's doing the similar, Stockton's ramping up. But we have the shelter beds, you have a beginning place. You have an entry point where you can now engage versus out in the streets, and they may or may not be around their encampment when you go looking for them.
I know there are some housing projects that are currently in development. You said you're not going to stop those, but would you approve any new housing projects, you know, when you're saying your model would be shelter first? Would you approve any new housing?
Oh, we have to improve housing. In fact, I believe the city can be a partner, public-private partner. What can we do to lower the startup fees? How about we suspend and reduce some of the permitting fees instead of it costing $1 million or $2 million for permits? How about we lower it down to 25% of that? So just get something started. How about we have land that we can bring forward in the county? We're doing this right now. We're about to offer land at a discount price to low-income housing development in what is essentially a county park, vastly underutilized. So then we're gonna have housing with recreation and family access and sports and a high quality of life utilizing county land. So you need to have public and private partnerships. The government's not the answer. The government, we need to be a facilitator to address and satisfy some of the great ideas that we have that you can partner with local nonprofits, with faith-based organizations, with grassroots organizations that can make a difference.
And you also mentioned, you know, crime and public safety a little bit earlier. There are a lot of different ways, you know, people and public officials have talked about tackling crime. What's one thing that you would want to do that's different than what we're seeing right now in terms of how you would address public safety issues in Stockton?
So again, first off, vocational education, job training. Nothing's going to improve the not only quality of life but lessen the degree of criminal activity and graffiti and all the blight than a job. That job's going to make a difference, and you give kids a hope, a gateway, a pathway to do something where they can put energy. How about we open up our recreation centers and created an inner city sports league. So basketball, tracks, you know, swimming, tennis, you name it, we create a little mini Olympics in the city of Stockton so that you've got volunteers, sometimes you get retired firefighters, retired or active duty police officers, volunteering time for sports leagues. Now you're building relationships, now you're mentoring, and you're creating a foundation that these young men and women will have not only great experiences, character development, but they can have pride in their community. We, back in New York years ago when I was a boxer, we used to have the Empire State Games. It was a mini Olympics annually inside the state of New York. Let's do that in Stockton. What you'd have is young men and women from South Stockton competing against young men and women in North Stockton, building friendships. Instead of being adversarials on the roadway because you cut me off or you're from a different neighborhood, how about now you have forged friendships in a sports and activity? Nothing builds greater bonds than that. And as a place to put energy, as a way to have levels of achievement and pride.
And we know, programs are all about, preventing crime. But when it comes to responding to crime, we know that the police force has been under a lot of stress the past few years with not enough officers. So what would you do specifically to recruit and retain more officers in Stockton?
So I have zero claim to this. The city of Stockton has already renegotiated and extended the special tax. They've renegotiated hiring contracts. I have a next door neighbor's police officer. He told me he's getting a 28% pay raise. So I would have no claim to and I'm going to fix that. You have a current mayor, you have a current city council, you have a city manager. They're addressing this issue and they know it's a call to action that they took. So we want to make sure that we're supporting our first responders, fire, police, safety in every capacity. The city of Lathrop, which I'm proud to represent as a county supervisor, every year they do a first responders day. Great big giant picnic and food and hot dogs and hamburgers and all given for free for the community to come out and celebrate our first responders. Let's show gratitude to them. Let's build those relationships, especially if they're doing sports leagues and they're part of it. This is just a way to enhance and bridge that the division or the separation where you're isolated. I've lived in New York City and you have police officers walking streets, right? Well, that's much more personable than driving down the street and passing by. How could you build a relationship? Why don't we open up what we used to have? Does that sound going to be okay?
Yeah.
Okay. So once upon a time, we used to have satellite police stations right here in the city of Stockton. Let's get back to that. Let's have a presence where, and we know statistically, wherever you locate satellite police stations, you have a reduction in crime. We know where the high crime zones are. So let's bring officers to have a presence and build relationships in the community with Neighborhood Watch and any other associations that are there.
I want to ask you, on your campaign website, you asked supporters to sign a petition for the Homelessness, Drug Addiction, and Theft Reduction Act. Is that in response to Prop 47? Is that something that would benefit Stockton residents locally, or is that a more broad, overarching California mission?
It's going to be for the entire state of California, okay? We see local businesses going out because of the open theft up to $900 or something. We see a lot of people complaining about them in the grocery store. Somebody comes by, grabs something, bumps into me, and walks out the door with it. And that's behavior that businesses cannot continue to sustain. That's a bad idea. The way it was worded, the way it was passed, it sounded good, like we're doing a service to people that are living in just trying to survive. But the reality is it's being taken advantage of, and there's a lot of effect. You see businesses being shut down, jobs going away, entire regions being impacted by this. It's not a good idea. So if we can repeal that and we start supporting our retail, local mom and pop businesses, then you're going to have an improvement to your economy. So we need to support that, and it's a statewide initiative that I fully support so that, as a business owner, as an employer, as a person that pays taxes and works with, has a local workforce, I know what we need to do to enhance opportunities locally.
And you believe that would impact Stockton?
Of course.
It
would impact everyone.
Okay.
I mean, local retailers are having a hard time. You've got jobs that are going away because of loss that's happening. You've got retail stores that are closing up. You've got impact that's up and down the state. Absolutely.
You talked also earlier, really briefly, just about, creating a more vibrant city, right, with arts and sports and all this kind of stuff. Well, do you have a specific plan for downtown Stockton, including the waterfront? You know, we're here right now. A lot of people have been saying for years a very underutilized area of the city. Do you have any specific plans on how you would boost that up?
So first off, partnership, public-private partnerships, right? Government doesn't have the ideas or the best ideas. We can work with those that want to and even incentivize, give them tax breaks or give them some incentive to participate. How about we do an EIR so that we take away the guesswork of what's required to make land viable and accessible for its development? Work with architectural firms, work with developers. Like, here's an idea, we've done the EIR report, we're going to help offset some of the startup costs. We're going to get you this land at a discount price as long as you operate it. If you sell it for profit, then you're going to owe us some money, right? But there's things we could do to partner and incentivize the private sector. It's not government. The government is not the answer. The government can facilitate and partner with the private sector to incentivize it and make it successful. So we have enterprise zones. So we have opportunities for employment. Bring in a convention center, bring in a hotel, family entertainment, a music venue, downtown Stockton, anchored in downtown Stockton. So when you start doing that, now you've got people coming in, you have a spillover effect, people going to the local restaurants. Now you have people going like, we are so busy. Things have been our sales, and we were able to employ more people. We're able to give raises. The demand for our workforce is so high. We have to pay more. Absolutely. Fantastic. Let's go for it.
And I know, you know, it's no secret that you have very strong opinions, and you've been known to maybe ruffle some feathers in the past. A lot of work that the mayor does is in partnership with city council members, other community leaders. How would you, ensure to voters that you'd be able to work closely and collaboratively with those people?
Well, you come across divisive or even times malicious people that have ulterior motives, and you can't help that. In spite of that, you work with those that want to get things done. In the Board of Supervisors, we had plenty of that, but guess what? We still took care of business. As a mayor, you have to work with city council members that represent six different regions. So what do we have in common? You sit down with each of them. What's your needs? Fantastic. You know, it's interesting. Those are similar needs elsewhere. You know, it's interesting. We've heard about the same needs that are going to be a cross-section of interest here in the entire city, right? Well, now you take that as a narrative and a mandate to the city manager. You go, okay, this is what we need to do. This is what the voters are expressing. This is what the citizens need. And we need to work together to accomplish these goals. What's the top priority? What's next? What's next? What's next? And you go through the pecking order. But it's in partnership. There's nothing I've done as a supervisor, A, that's self-serving, or B, that isn't to the benefit of a community. I have never done anything to the benefit of individual interest to the detriment of a community. And I'm very proud of my record of working, so when I make a decision, to make certain that it benefits the community, not a single interest. And I have every level of pride of things I've accomplished to address public safety, to address, you know, expanding job opportunities, which absolutely has happened under my watch, and even more. I did, over at Delta College, I initiated 1,000 jobs for 1,000 students, paid internship jobs for students going to Delta. Nobody's done that in the state of California. I partnered with then-president Porzan Johnny at Delta College. We brought in county dollars, and the board supported it. Even though there might be some divisive opinions on the board, we supported it by majority, and we got it done. Resounding success. Awesome. We partnered with an education institution. We as a board worked together, found a winner, and it's been a fantastic success.
Lastly, we are just a few days away from Election Day. What's your final message to voters?
So my final message is, you have to appreciate and let's recognize that there's a lot of people running for office, and they have a passion, and they have a voice to be involved and make a difference. And I welcome, and I'm glad that everybody that's running for office. One distinct difference between myself and others running for mayor is results. I look for results. And if you look at what I've accomplished as a county supervisor, things that I've initiated, not following staff, working with staff, or asking more from staff and bringing ideas forward that we incorporate. I've got a record of 20, 30 things that I've initiated into San Joaquin County that have had a profound difference. Now's the time to bring it to the city and roll over those relationships, the relationships from the city working with the county, and having a conduit to address the biggest challenges that we have right here in our city that also permeate throughout the county. We do more together than we do by working in an isolated manner. And that's, I believe, as a mayor, you work with the city manager, you work with your city council, you work with your supportive infrastructure around you, staff and other agencies, local nonprofits, faith-based organizations, the county, work with them. It's like, let's bring this together so there aren't silos. We aren't isolated. We are one county, we are one city, and what happens here affects other areas that we need to come together and work in a collaborative sense.